The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text number 12 and 13, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on July 30th, 1966, in New York.
सिद्धि भवती कर्मजा पीपल दे आर नेचुरली फॉलोइंग लीडरशिप बट दे डू नॉट वांट टू फॉलो द लीडरशिप ऑफ श्री कृष्ण बिकॉज दे वांट immediate relief from the misery of this world. They do not want a permanent solution of all misery. Krishna, if we accept the leadership of Krishna, then in this very life we can make a solution of all the miseries of material existence. But instead of following the leadership of Krishna, we accept leadership which is also indirectly the leadership of Krishna, but it is misrepresented because on account of contamination of this material nature. Material nature is inferior or lower nature. Constitutionally, we are following the leadership, but we want immediate temporary relief for our misery. We do not want permanent solution of all misery. That is the defect of our life. But here is a chance. If we follow the leadership of Krishna, then we make a solution of the whole misery. Tankanta, tankanta, sadharmanam siddhi jadanta yadivata kipram hi manusi loke siddhi bhavati karmaja. Karmaja means those who are acting here on the line of creative activity. Suppose you have experienced that there are so many political leaders, they follow some particular leader and they capture the governmental machinery. But after some time, they are taken away from the scene. Just like in our country, recently, within 1 year, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, he is also shifted away. Shastri is also shifted away. In your country, the President Kennedy is also shifted away. We do not take into account that after shifting this position, again we are going to enter into the miserable life of material existence. If we do not make a solution in present life, then we are again going to enter. Suppose in this life I am elected to be the president of this great state, United States of America, and if my next life I become an ordinary citizen or even an animal, there is no guarantee what I shall become in my next life. That depends on my work, because the whole body is given by the material nature. It is not made according to my order supply. Prakitekriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasa. You are given a chance to act here. But according to your act, it will be judged what you are going to have in your next life. That is your problem. No, don't make this life of 50 years, 60 years, or 70 years, or 100 years as all in all. You have got a continuous life of transmigration from one body to another. It is going on. You must know that. Now here is a chance to stop this nonsense of transmigrating from one body to another and suffer the material misery. Here is a chance. And how that chance you are going to utilize, that we have already discussed. Tatta deham punarjanma naiti maneti kaunteya. If somebody simply studies critically the transcendental nature of Krishna, the transcendental nature of his activities, simply by knowing this, the benefit will be that tatta deham, after quitting this body, you are not again going to have such a material body. But tatta deham punarjan, punarjanana, you are not going to take your birth again in the womb of a mother of this material nature. So, just believe it. It is standard. It is accepted by all the great stalwarts, scholars, and acharyas of repute. Just like Shankaracharya, Ramanucharya, Madhyacharya, great scholars and acharyas. They have accepted it. Mahajana Dhena Tatastha Pantha. We have to follow the footprints of great saints and sages, those who have achieved success by this indication of Bhagavad Gita. Don't follow your whims. Take the standard advice. Just try to become Krishna conscious. Just try to understand Krishna. What is Krishna? And the result is that after leaving this body, you are no more going to accept any material body, but you enter into the spiritual kingdom and you have your spiritual body which is eternal, full of knowledge and blissful. This is the chance. Krishna says, although the chance is there to people out of foolishness, exactly this very word has been used in the 7th chapter. Namam duskitanam muha prapadante naradhama mayaya aparita jnana asuri bhavama asrita. He has used very strong words. The persons who are miscreants, do not care for vice or virtue, never mind. They don't care which is vice and which is virtue. Such persons, duskritina, those who are always engaged in vicious work, and those who are foolish, namang duskitanam murha, prapadante naradhama. Naradhama means lowest of the mankind. And maya apuhita jnana, and one whose knowledge is deluded by the external energy. These people, they do not reject the shelter of Krishna. They do not like, although the opportunity is open for everyone. But we may not be like the miscreants, foolish, and waste of the mankind. Let us become intelligent. Krishna consciousness is not very difficult job. It is the easiest and the highest, topmost type of yoga system in the 12th chapter. You will find it explicitly stated that one who always in devotional service of Krishna, he is the first class yogi. One who is always constantly in Krishna consciousness, he is the first class yogi. And that is also stated in the last verse of the 6th chapter also. And it is accepted by great scholars and acharyas. So, here is an opportunity. It is very simple. Very simple. Simply thinking of Krishna. Tatatam chintaye Vishnu. Mattabdam satato Vishnu. Vishmattabdam najatasi. Always simply if you think that Hare Krishna. If you think simply, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. That is sufficient. Even if you do not go into the Bhagavad Gita, if you do not go into the Srimad Bhagavatam, simply as you are chanting, Krishna has given us the ear and Krishna has given us the tongue. No expense, no difficulty. You haven't got to go to college and take degree to become Krishna conscious. It is easy for the rich, for the poor, for the learned, for the fool, for the black, for the white, for the rich, for the poor, everyone. There is no distinction. Because Krishna is for everyone. Mani-pata-vipa-sikta-deti-supapajana. In the lower nature, everyone thinks, oh, I am better than you. The Hindu thinks, we are better than Muslim. The Muslim thinks we are better than Hindus. The Christian thinks you are better than the Jews. The Jews thinks you are better than... This is material conception. But for Krishna, there is no lower or higher. Every living being is part and parcel. He comes here to claim everyone. Come on. Come on, my dear son. Why you are suffering this? It is not for you. Take this down. Jada jada hi dharmasya prani bhavati bharata. So, Krishna consciousness is so nice, but one who does not care for it, they are satisfied by some temporary leave and they take to other courses. They do not take the leadership of Krishna. Tāṅkhantaṁ karanāṁ siddhiṁ yajanta iha devata. Iha devata means is material gods. Material gods means their existence is so long this material world. That's like here we have got the president, the governor and so many big officers. But suppose somehow or other the whole planet or the whole thing is gone, destroyed, because we can expect destruction every moment. Bhutta bhutta praliyate. Then the whole thing, I mean to say, the president and the governor, everything is gone. So we are taking center of this material world, something big. But that will not exist with the annihilation, with the dissolution of this material world. Everything will be dissolved. Everything is Gita. So we have to take the leadership of the Supreme. Then it will be the largest perfection, the greatest perfection of life. Now, Lord Krishna says, Karmanam Siddhi, how they, in the material world, people are working. He is analyzing the process of different occupations. What is that? Chatutbandang maya system gunatagma vibhavasan tasva kattaramapi mana vidhi apattaram abhyam. The Lord says that Chatutbandam, four castes or four divisions of human society. You have heard that there is caste system in India. There is caste system in India. Sometimes Indians are criticized by the outsider that they have caste system. But here the Lord says, the Chatutbandam Maya system Gunatanma Vibhagata. This caste system is created by me. How? Gunakarma vibhagasa, according to quality and according to work. That division in the human society, according to quality and according to work, is there. In everywhere in the world, not only everywhere in the world, but everywhere in the universe. God's creation cannot be stopped. Just like in God's creation, there is sun, there is moon, there is seasonal changes. Nobody can stop this. Similarly, the Chatutbandam, and according to quality and karma, that division prevails all over the universe, not only in India, but also in your country also, in your country. And what are these divisions? Now, what are the gun and karma? The gun, the quality. There are three qualities in the material world. There are three qualities. The quality of goodness, the quality of passion, and the quality of ignorance. And either human being or animal or demigods or American or Indian, everywhere these qualities are working. So some of them are in the modes or quality of goodness. And some of them are in the quality of passion. And some of them are in the quality of ignorance. Those who are in the quality of goodness, they are called Brahmins or the intelligent class of men. In Sanskrit language, because intelligence does not mean to know, to have some knowledge of the material things. Intelligence means to know about the spiritual world also. That is intelligence. Because as you know that I am combination of matter and spirit. I am spirit and I am now entangled in this material body. I am spirit consciousness, as soon as I am out of this body, I can distinguish I cannot distinguish, so I go away, you can distinguish. That now this real family spirit is gone, the family material body is here. That can so it is very plain thing. So therefore, we should not only have perfect knowledge of this matter, but we should have perfect knowledge of the spirit also, if you are actually intelligent. Therefore, the Brahmins, why they are called Brahmins? Brahma janati iti Brahman. Brahmins is the English and translation, but real word is Brahman, Brahman. And where from this Brahman word comes? Brahma janati iti Brahmana. That means one who knows the spirit, the spiritual, one who has got complete knowledge of the spiritual world, he is called Brahman. How one becomes Brahmana? Now, here you will find distinctly the Chaturbannam Maya system Gunakarma Vibhagasa. The four divisions of qualitative division is set by me according to quality and karma. Never said according to birth. According to birth, it is not said here. Although in India it is now misrepresented that a Brahmin son is trying to designate himself as Brahman, but according to Bhagavad Gita, that is not sanctioned. Bhagavad Gita says according to quality. Now just like here is a qualified lawyer, Mr. Goldsmith, he is lawyer. Now, because he is lawyer, his son cannot claim that because my father is lawyer, that I am also lawyer. How it can be done? The son also must be qualified lawyer. He must pass a bachelor of law degree examination. Then he can be done. Similarly, here Krishna says, don't misunderstand the Indian caste system as hereditary. No. It is according to Vedic literature. It is according to the quality. And what is that quality? Janmana jayate sudra. Janmana jayate sudra. Anyone who takes his birth, by his birth, he is a Sudra. Sudra means the lowest, in the lowest order. Everyone, even if he is born in the family of a Brahmin, he is to be considered as a Sudra, Janmana, by birth. And perhaps some of you know that the Brahmins, the Kshatriyas and the Vaishyas, they are called Bija. B means twice, and Ja means birth. Twice born. The bird is also called twice born. Why? The birth is first of all in the egg. So the egg is fermented, then the real bird comes out. Therefore, bird is called in Sanskrit language also Bija, twice born. Similarly, a man, unless he is twice born, he is a Sudra. Twice born. How is that twice born? Because by birth, everyone has got some father and mother. Because without father and mother, there is no question of birth. So the beast has also got father and mother, and the bird has also father and mother. Similarly, a human being has also got father and mother. So this birth by father and mother is not sufficient for becoming a bija. He has to take his birth again. So janmana jayate sudra samskara bhavet bija. Birth is not all, everything. The culture, samskara means culture. One has to take his birth, rebirth, by culture, by education, by knowledge. That is called cultural birth. So unless one is in the cultural birth, he is to be considered the lower grade person or the sudra. So therefore, the system is according to Varnasam Dharma, that not only by birth, before birth, when the father and mother is going to be combined to beget a child, there are cultural samskar or reformatory measures. How much carefully these things that they wanted first class son. Not sons like cats and dogs. First class son. So there is some samskar. There is some purificatory measure, which is called garbhadhan samskar. Garbhadhan means pregnancy. The cultural ceremony before making the mother pregnant. And it is enjoined, you will find in the Bhagavad, that any family, the Brahmins, the Kshatriya and Vaishyas, if they give up this Garbhadhan samskar and the birth giving ceremony, then that family turns immediately to the classification of the Sudra. So nowadays, at the present moment, this cultural program, I am speaking of India and everywhere, there is no such cultural program. That cultural program, that program to beget nice children, the whole program is, we must know, the whole baby system is to give the human life the greatest chance of self-realization and get free from this material misery. That is the whole program. It is not, the baby culture does not mean that we shall be like cats and dogs simply eating, sleeping, mating and defending. No. The human society is a systematic program to give everyone the chance of getting free from this material misery. Just like every state is supposed to be welfare state, every citizen of that state should be happy, should be prosperous, there should be no anxiety. I do not know if every state is taking care of the citizens in that way. People are always full of anxiety. They are creating situation that everyone is full of anxiety. This material world is made so that it is full of anxiety. Whoever is in the material world, and even the bird will see, when it is taking some grain, he is also full of anxiety. He is looking like this and that. Oh, somebody is coming or killing me. So this is the nature. The human society. Human society is so arranged that the people, the members of the human society, should be free from all anxiety. Therefore we require good citizens, good father and mother, good system of government and pious, virtuous cooperation between God and nature, everything will be helpful for my spiritual realization, for my self-realization. If I am full of anxiety, how can I make progress in spiritual realization? It is not possible. Therefore, it is the duty of the state, duty of the scholar, duty of the teacher, duty of the spiritual master to give chance to the small children to develop in such a way that he becomes fully realized spiritual soul at the end, and so that his miserable life in the material existence is over. That is the responsibility. In Bhagavad he says that Rishabhde said that one should not become the spiritual master. One should not become the father. One should not become the mother. One should not become the husband who cannot give relief from these miseries of material existence. It is the husband's duty also, because the wife is under the protection of the husband. He has got so much responsibility. Woman class and children class, they are taken in the same category. They require protection. They require protection. That is the Manusanghita. Nasyang satantakam arhati. Women should be under the protection. They should be given all protection. So, the system of taking, that's just like the Hindu system is, that's the world. Before attaining the age of puberty, he is handed over to a suitable boy to take charge before he gets his full energy. So this is the system of Varnashramdharma. This is the system. The whole idea is that everyone should be given the chance of being liberated in this very life. No more waiting for again for father another life. Who knows that I am going to be human being again? It may be by freaks of nature I become a cat, a dog, a cow, an animal. Now we are very much enthusiastic to become good national. Suppose I am American, a very good national. Now, after that, suppose that I become a cow, then even I am national of this country, I am destined to be sent to the slaughterhouse. So we should not take the risk of next birth in this life. In this birth, we should make a permanent solution of all misery. That is Krishna conscious. Let us become Krishna conscious in this very life and make a solution. Now this Chatuvarnam, this plan, a Chatuvarnam, Lord said, you should always remember that this material creation, whole material creation, there are unlimited number of universes and, planets in each universe. In the Brahma Samhita it is stated, yasya prabha prabhavato jagadanda kochi. Jagadanda kochi. Jagadanda means this universe, and koti means 100 million, 100 million. not exactly 100 million, but numberless. Jasya prabhāprabhato jagadanda koti koti śyāsesu vasudhādi vibhūti hinnam tad brahma niṣkalam anantam asesu bhūtam govindam adipurusam tamaham bhajāme. So this material world is created. It is created for temporary existence. Bhutta bhutta praliyate is hand in the Bhagavad Gita. This material manifestation is temporary, maybe for millions of years, but it is temporary. And why this temporary material world is created? Just to give the rebels, I am to say, living entities, who are averse to God consciousness, Krishna consciousness, to give another chance for development. So if you miss this chance, then again when this material world will be dissolved, oh, do not know how many millions of years you have to become unconscious, a human in the unconscious sleeping state. Then again there will be creation. Then again our body will be created. These are very subtle laws. We should not miss. We should be very serious about this law. So the whole program is made, Chatudvandanam Maya system. So by birth, one is supposed to be the lower. Janmana Jayati Sudra. Sudra means without any culture. The man who has no cultural life, he is called a Sudra. And those who have culture, they are called Bija. Bija means twice born. So one has to take his birth twice. He should not be satisfied simply by taking birth by the father and mother. One should be anxious to take his twice born, to become twice born, Brahmin. But that chance is, don't think that you cannot become a Brahmin. You cannot become a qualified Brahmin, provided you abide by the qualification of a qualified man. Just like to become a lawyer, it is not limited to a certain section or to a certain person. Anyone who takes the qualification of a lawyer, he becomes a lawyer. Similarly, here Lord says, Chatudvarna Maya Sushtam Gunatarna Vibhava. According to quality and karma, these Chatudvarna four classes or four tasks or four classes of division of the human society is created by me. So Brahma Janati is Brahmana. If you want to know Brahma, because that is a prerogative of your life, human life, Vedanta Sutra says, Athata Brahma Jigyasa. Athata Brahma Jigyasa. Oh, here is the chance for inquiring about Brahma. Athata Brahma Jigyasa. No. So we should take this chance to become a Brahmin as soon as we begin to inquire about Brahma or the Supreme Brahma, Krishna. Then my process of becoming the Brahmin begins. You know that the Brahmins, the Kshatriyas and the Vaishyas, they are called the sacred trade. You have seen, I have got the sacred trade. This is of course not very valuable, it is made of cotton. But this is a badge. This badge is given to a person who is twice born. So anyone can become twice born. There is no hindrance. You'll find in the Bhagavad Gita, Manghi Pasantakasitya, Jepi Supapajuna, Priyarusha Tasu Sudra, Sri Vilanti Parangatin, Sinkuna Brahmana Punya Rajas, Vatka Rajas Vaisatha, Kompya Pratijan Hi, Namai Bhakta Pranastati. So, it is a chance. We should not miss. You can become Brahman. there is chance. He should not be satisfied that I am born in America. So I am great, I am born of a great nation, that's all right. You are born of a great nation, that's all right. But next cultural birth to become a vizier, twice born, is awaiting. The Lord Krishna says, yes, I give chance to everyone to become vizier. Mahi Patra Prakashita Jyotishi Kapajuna. Never mind. Wherever he is born. Now the human society, everyone thinks that he is low, I am big. Or everyone thinks. In his own consideration, he thinks I am the biggest, I am the big, and he is lower. That is everyone. But Lord Krishna is not considering who is bigger. So he says, even he is considering that I am low-born. Because if everyone says that I am low-born, it is propaganda, that you are low-born, you are low-born. So I think, yes, I am low-born. Dasa-chakri Bhagavan Bhut. This time there was a clique, and there was a Brahmin, his name was Bhagavan. So he had some enemy. So the enemies, they sat down in 10 places, and wherever he was passing, oh, you have become ghost, you have become ghost. How am I? Because I am living, I am living. Next post he goes, he also says, oh, you have become ghost, you have become ghost. In this way, he passes 10 posts, he thinks, oh, I have become ghost. Otherwise, everyone says, I have become ghost. So Dasa-chakra Bhagavan says. So if everybody says I am low-born, I am low-born, so I also think I am low-born. But I am not low-born. I am Brahmasmi. I am Brahmasmi. I am finished soul. I am born of Krishna. Krishna is my father. Think like that. Think like that. That is twice born. That is twice born. Krishna says, Manghi Pata Dapathita, anyone who takes shelter of me, never mind what he is. Never mind. He may be low born, he may be a Sudra, he may be a woman, he may be whatever he may be. He is anti parangati. He can also go to my kingdom. So our duty is to become twice born just by culture, by Krishna consciousness. Let us take another birth. Let us take another birth. Then you will be recognized, Brahmin, Brahma Janati. As soon as you know Krishna, you are Brahman. Never mind whether you are born in America or Czechoslovakia or any other place. Doesn't matter. So try to become a Brahmin. Here is a chance. But how to become a Brahmin? Simply by purchasing 2 cents worth this bread and getting on the body? No. There are qualities. Karma. You have to act like a Brahmin. And you have to acquire the qualification of a Brahmin. Then you can become a Brahmin. There is no impediment. Never mind wherever you are born. That doesn't matter. So here is Bhagavad Gita. He is giving a chance to everyone to become Brahmin or the qualified person who knows Brahma and who is preparing himself for the next birth in the spiritual kingdom. He is called Brahmin. Jagatmanamaya system. Now Lord says, Tattva Pattaram api mana vidhi apattaram abhyam. Although I have created this system, still I am not there. Why? Because Krishna is neither Brahmin nor Sudra nor Kshatri or anything, anything of the material world. He is transcendental. When we go to Krishna, his spiritual body, we also become like Krishna in transcendental body. That chance is given here. Thus, it is our duty, everyone, the Lord Chaitanya, he is Krishna himself, he appeared as a devotee of Krishna, but he never said that I am Krishna, but from basic references to understand that he is Krishna. But the same mission, the Krishna's mission and Lord Chaitanya's mission is the same. How it is same? Krishna, as the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he says that you surrender unto me. And Lord Chaitanya says, you surrender unto Krishna. The same thing. Lord Chaitanya says, what is the philosophy of Lord Chaitanya? Lord Chaitanya says, Aradha Bhagavan Udhaja Chaitanya Tadhyamam Vrindavanam Ramakasi Upasana Vajavadhu Vargavi Jakalpita Vibhada Bhagavatam Mamalam Puranam Prema Pumarthumahan Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Matamidam Satradara Naparaha. The philosophy of Lord Chaitanya is that the Krishna is the only object of worship. And as Krishna is object of worship, similarly, he is place, Vrindavan, Vrindavan Dham. Those who have visited India, Vrindavan Dham is still, if you go to Vrindavan, without knowing about Krishna, you will at once feel Krishna consciousness. You will set a nice place. So that Vrindavan Dham is also worshipping. And Brahma Akadit Upasana Vrajamadhu Vargavi Kajakalpita. Now, Krishna was worshipped by the dancers of Vrajadham. Lord Chaitanya recommends that is the highest, topmost grade of worship. Because that was pure love. The dancers of Vraja love Krishna so much, without any return. That is sublime. So he recommended. That is the highest form of worship. Brahmakaji Upasana Vrajavadhuvijakalpita Srimad Bhagavatam Mamalam Puranam. And Srimad Bhagavat is the spotless Vedic literature. Because Srimad Bhagavatam is full of Krishna consciousness only. Just like this Bhagavad Gita is full of Krishna consciousness. It is the preliminary study of Srimad Bhagavatam. The last word of the Srimad Bhagavad Gita is the Sarvadhanman Parityajya Mamekam Saranam Vraja. You give up everything, you just surrender unto me. Krishna says, one who accepts this philosophy, that I accept Krishna as a Vasudeva Sarvameti Samatma Sudhullava, then for him Srimad Bhagavatam is the post-graduate study. And Srimad Bhagavatam Mamalam Puranam Prema Pumartha Maha. Now, we are searching our self-interest. Everyone is busy of his own interest, but they do not know what is real interest. They do not know what is real interest. The real interest is to invoke the dormant love of Krishna. That is my real interest. That dormant love for Krishna is there in every one of you. Don't think that because I am born in India, therefore I have got love of Krishna within my heart, dormant or manifested. No. That dormant love of Krishna is within you also. Krishna is neither foreign to you or foreign to me. He is for everyone. Therefore, love of Krishna is there permanently, but it is covered. Simply, it has to be invoked. And what is this process of invoking? This is the process. Just like you are discussing, you are chanting, and you are reading Bhagavad Gita, you are reading Srimad Bhagavatam, this association will help us. This association will help us to invoke that dormant Krishna consciousness. So, if we at all want, if we interested in hearing a story, not story, it is actual fact. One of my god brothers is no longer in this world. His name was Bhaktisaranga Goswami. He went to London. Just as I come to New York, he went to London and he formed a society also there, in which Lord Donaldson, the Marquis of Jetland, he was formerly governor of Bengal during this period. And in our childhood, when we were college students, in boyhood, I saw him. He is very interested in Indian philosophy. He is a smart man, but very interested, Lord Ronaldson. So, that Lord Ronaldson, he was very kind enough to become the president of the society, my god brother, organized in London. Now, Lord Ronaldson, and that my god brother is talking, so Lord Ronaldson asked him, "Well, Swamiji, can you make me a brahmin?" "Yes, why not?" "Yes, why not? You can become a brahmin." "So, what are the conditions?" My god brother said, "The preliminary four conditions." "What are these conditions?" "The priyasana, panagrita, jatrapapa, satudvila." "You cannot have any illicit connection with woman. You cannot have any intoxication habits. You cannot indulge in gambling or unnecessary sporting. And you cannot live on animal food." Lord Donald's reply is impossible. It is impossible. So, these things, these four principles, preliminary, if we actually want to be a Brahmin, then we have to take care of these four principles of love, just to become a Brahmin. Yes. Then everyone can become a Brahmin. There is no bar. And whoever becomes a Brahmin, he knows what is Brahma. And Krishna is Parabrahma. Parabrahma. We find in the 10th chapter, he is addressed by Arjuna. Parabrahma, Paramadhama, Pavittam, Paramam Bhavam. By studying Bhagavad Gita, I now understand that Krishna, you are Parabrahma. Paramdhama, you are the center of everyone. So, he is Parabrahma. So, anyone who becomes a Brahmin, he first of all knows what is Brahma. Brahma Jigyasa, the Supreme, the Absolute Truth. And the Absolute, one who knows Absolute Truth and enters into further post-graduate study, he understands Krishna. And as soon as he understands Krishna, then his next life in the spiritual world is guaranteed. So this is the process of Krishna consciousness. This is the simple process introduced by Lord Krishna, Lord Chaitanya. Lord Chaitanya also supported this philosophy of Krishna, that anyone is eligible for going back to the kingdom of Krishna. The simple process that is also stated in Bhagavad Gita, we have discussed that simply by knowing the transcendental nature of Krishna, we become eligible for entering this kingdom. Simply by knowing. Just try to know. try to study what is Krishna. And do you know what is the recommendation of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he said that Shiva Sudra, Shiva Vipra, Nasikane Nod, Jai Krishna Tattavetta Sai Guruha. That means, it doesn't matter whether he is a householder, or a Swami, renounce order, or a Brahmin, or a Sudra, or a low one, whatever he is, that doesn't matter. If he knows the science of Krishna, he is a bona fide spiritual master. If he simply knows the science of Krishna, this is Chaturvarna Maya Krishna Gunakam. It is the quality. That's why, if I go to a medical man or a lawyer, we go there for his qualification. We don't ask him, well, sir, are you Christian, are you Jew, are you Indian, or American, or Brahmin? No. We are concerned with the qualification. It doesn't matter what he is. He may be an American, he may be an Indian, he may be a Christian, he may be Jew, he may be Hindu or Muslim, it doesn't matter. He is a practice, medical practitioner, so he is a qualified man. I have gone there for my treatment. Similarly, Lord Chaitanya also says the same thing, and Krishna also says the same thing. Never. It is he is chasing on birth. Birth is no consolation. Nobody is responsible for his birth. He may be low body, but what is that? Or he may be high body. Well, that doesn't matter. But when he comes out from the womb of the mother, he has got his own responsibility. He has to advance his cultural life in Krishna consciousness. That is his responsibility. That is his responsibility. Of course, father, mother, state, teacher, friend, they can help us, but ultimately the responsibility lies with me. If I want to enter into the kingdom of God or Krishna, if we want to be Krishna consciousness, there is no impediment. There is no impediment. Ahitakiya pratihata. And the Bhagavad says that if one wants to cultivate the Krishna consciousness, it is without any cause and without any impediment. Because it is transcendental subject matter. It does not depend on any material condition. On any material condition. There is no consideration of material impediment. So it is open for everyone. Chaturvarna Maya system. That is a chance given that you can become a Brahmin, you can become a great devotee of Lord Krishna, and you can become the spiritual master of the world. That is the... And I think, if you take seriously, I am old man, if you, some of you, at least, understand the science and take up the science, you become a future home of this country, or the world. That is my request to you, that you should take this chance and become a spiritual master for all the people. Thank you very much.